12 o'clock on a Wednesday, and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
I'm Craig.
It's not going to do it. It's not a chance.
No. Just before we start the show, we should point out Blammo's not well, and also not happy with Dave, because Dave went and gave him a little good operation.
It's for his own good. He's had his Goshman's taken away. So
yeah, he's not the dog that he used to be right now. He's feeling a little bit down.
They're going to hate me.
Yeah, you've robbed him of his manhood.
No, he's going to stop him doing like 40 wees when we're out on a walk.
Crazy. So you've chopped his bits off for your own personal.
Enough of that.
Okay,
please. You know, I was distraught last night when
as distraught as he was, I imagine. Anyway, moving on.
First up this week is anime subtitle.
The Blowing of Life.
A Blowing of Life.
Yeah, that is the subtitle.
That's how good you feel when you perform this.
You want to blow life. It's by Verne, the man that bought us a million plastic bits and bobs. The effect is basically...
two effects, isn't there?
Is there?
Two effects.
Oh, yeah, of course there is. Yeah,
bonus
effect. The main effect, the effect that I consider to be the main effect, is the haunted deck. Now, if you've not seen the haunted deck before, and I can't imagine who hasn't, the idea
is... We get very nice history on the DVD.
You do get very nice
history. And he shows a pamphlet that's very old that he picked up at a car boot sale.
First time I saw the haunted deck was, I think, Eugene Berger's handling.
Yes, absolutely.
Many years ago. If you haven't seen it, you have someone pick a card. The card's put back in the deck. You hold onto the deck and it's placed on your outstretched hand, and then the deck slowly cuts itself at one card. It is the card that the spectator selected. Now, what this version has going for it, first of all, it can be done with any deck.
Yeah.
Including a borrowed deck. You could literally borrow a deck of cards.
It's true.
There's no setup to it at all.
No, you get a gimmick, but the gimmick, we'll actually put the gimmick on display. It looks like a garage door remote, doesn't it?
Yeah, and it fits on your
keyring. It looks like a remote control device.
Yeah, so if you've got a key, I've got a key fob set up with fob and Keymaster and Ring Flight Revolution.
Got a whole act on there.
I've basically got an act on my key fob.
So now you put your garage door remote on there and you're set up to do...
This.
A complete strolling set now.
Yeah, totally. I could just go out with my keys and I'm sorted. So it fits on your key fob. There's no angle issues at all. In fact, in the performance, he does it completely surrounded. There's no lighting issues at all. For those of you that know the original Haunted Deck, lighting was a major factor.
Let's have a little bit of a callback here. Do you remember when I reviewed Animate and Restore?
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
And Animate and Restore uses the same method as the Haunted Pack, the original Haunted Pack. Mm-hmm. But my main issue with it, if you search on worldmagicshop.com and go back and look at the review for Animate and Restore, you will see that I mentioned during that review that when you do the switch, the gimmick suddenly goes, whoa, there it is in view.
You can see it, yeah.
And because, at that point in the routine, the tension is released in the routining.
Yeah.
The tension is released and all of a sudden there's the gimmick for everybody to see.
Yeah.
The nice thing about this is you can keep the tension there in your performance all the time.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, totally.
And that is a strong point with this gimmick.
Those of you that don't know what Dave's talking about, basically, because you are talking a little bit of code if they don't know, what he basically means is it becomes not only angle proof, but lighting proof. You can do it outdoors, you can do it inside. You can also do it sitting down, standing up, strolling, completely surrounded. As soon as the effect happened, you can immediately hand the deck back out. So imagine it, you borrow a deck, you're immediately set to go into this routine. You have someone pick a card, it's put back in the deck cuts itself in your hand, and you immediately give them the cards to examine, and you are instantly reset for the next table, and you could do it in any environment. This gimmick is so clever. When I saw it, I immediately said, I have to have that.
Yeah.
Because the Haunted Deck, if you've never performed the Haunted Deck before, it is an incredibly strong effect.
The only version, I think, that is better than this, that I've seen, in the hands is Tom Wright's, because it's in their hands.
It's in their hands.
I think that is that's better, but there's a little bit...
And Tom does it amazingly.
But there's a little bit more of a setup to that, and I think it's something you would perform more in a professional gig situation.
Yes.
And I think Chill is better for that, because it's happening on their hands, and that you can't beat.
Fair enough.
But if you just want to walk around, you're just out on a night out...
You've got your keys in your pocket.
Like, there are tricks I do when I'm out on a night out, you know, that sort of thing, and they're not necessarily things that I would do when I'm performing.
And this is one
But I think now adding this to your key fob It's absolutely fantastic.
Yeah. And he doesn't talk about it, but you could do it with a stack of business cards if you wanted to.
Yeah.
It's very versatile. The second routine on there is, and I'll let Dave go off on this because I know he's not very happy about this.
Well, it's not that I'm not happy. You get, actually, the animated matchbox with it. And the matchbox is gimmicked in a certain way, so you can add the anime gimmick to it.
Yeah.
So it's nice that you get the matchbox there ready to perform with. If you like the animated matchbox effect, then this is a fantastic way to do it. It starts set up, but you end completely clean, nothing attached to the box.
For those of you that don't know, by the way, what the animated matchbox is, basically a matchbox stands up, opens itself, closes, you put a glass on it, it still stands up.
He does too much with it.
He goes on for ages.
It goes on, you know, first it's opening, then it's spinning, then it's on the back of his hand, then it's opening, and then it's under a glass, and it does too much.
The routine
if you could really do magic, you would put the matchbox on your hand, you'd cover it with the glass, it would rise up, open, and you'd immediately give it out. Yep. That's what you would
do. Which you could do with this gimmick.
Which you could do, and you're completely clean. My issue with it is, in the UK especially, because this trick made its way into a lot of commercially available magic sets in the 80s and that kind of thing.
I remember it was put in Nick Einhorn's book.
Yeah, well, a lot of people know the animated matchbox in the UK. I don't know what it's like in America, completely different maybe, or the rest of the world, but certainly in the UK, a lot of people know the animated matchbox.
Yeah, they do.
And, you know, matchboxes, they are out of favour these days, so it's not a natural object.
Yeah, that's fair enough.
How many people do you know that have matchboxes?
Nobody.
Yeah, you have them at bars and that kind of thing. And if you're going to do something special with the match, you have to make sure that what happens with that match...
Well, smokers are going out of fashion these days. But even if you're a smoker, you normally carry a lighter and not a box of matches.
Yeah, it's not as natural. But for the Haunted Pack, I think this gimmick is superb.
I'm
how much are you going to give it?
No, well, I'm going to get it. Well, you know, the criteria is if it goes into my act or it potentially could go into my act, it's over 90%. So I got to give this... 93%.
In fact, right, I'm going to give it 94%.
Okay.
I think we should give this Worker of the Week.
Definitely, because it is a worker. Think about the conditions. Very easy to do. You could watch the DVD. The DVD, by the way, is very well done.
English
he's not, the performance actually Spanish. Doesn't do it justice. The performance isn't as good as it actually is, you know?
Yeah, he's not that great at doing it. He says he's been doing it a long time, but I've seen people handle the Haunted Pack a little bit better, but he still does it very well. The footage on the trailer is excellent and actually better than the DVD because you don't see enough close-ups during the performance.
Totally. It's a worker. The bottom line is, there is not. It's very easy to do. Angle proof, sit up, sit down, instant reset. It's a worker. It definitely should get Worker of the Week.
We're going to do this as a Worker Special as well. You're giving it 93, I'm giving it 94. It's got a Worker Special. The Worker Special, anybody that orders this by midnight on Friday will be entered into a draw to win. Literally loads of magic. There's packet tricks there. There's props and that kind of thing. There's so much stuff. Literally, John has just gone around and gone, right, we'll put one of those in.
I noticed...
How many hundreds of pounds worth, John? Billion?
A billion.
100 billion pounds
worth of magic. Hey, I tell you what, I was watching you chuck this stuff into a little pile, and one of the things in there is a really nice Cartoon Possible location by Steve Shuffen that's really, really not well known.
And probably the star prize of all of those is a DVD set of the EMC.
EMC
2012. So it's worth a billion pounds in John's head.
Plus 120 for the EMC. So
plus 120.
£1,120,000.
Anybody that enters will be automatically entered into a prize draw, and we'll draw that in a couple of weeks' time on the Wizard Product Review. Worker of the Week, Anime by Vernet Magic. It's a nice prop.
It's really good.
Next up, we've got Captain and Coke. And you were like, oh, I'll have a look at this.
Yeah,
you
know, coin trick.
Thanks, John.
Yeah, just stating the obvious back there. It's by the...
Frustrated performer there behind the camera.
You know, this is how Mardy he is today, guys, right?
Oh!
He sat down behind the camera and he turned around to me and Dave and he said, can we have an on-the-stick special? I can't even be bothered to lift the camera.
Can we have an on-the-stick special? So we weren't going to get this off the sticks, but now we are.
Yeah, because we just want to annoy John, frankly, and that's what it is. So before I do anything, before I talk about this, let's get this off the sticks and we're going to do something.
Come on, John.
Get it. Oh, look how depressed he is when he's getting off the sticks.
He might not be able to see that.
So, we've got an American dime. No, that's a penny, isn't it? And a quarter. An American... quite an American.
Don't do accents. It's so bad. You just upset people.
Actually, I do, don't I?
Yeah.
Every time. Look, this is what we're going to do. Dave, I want you to hold on to the two coins. Squeeze them tightly.
Yeah.
Put your hands behind your back.
Okay.
Okay, and take the bigger one, the quarter, and put it in one hand, and keep the penny in the other hand. Bring your hands out in front of you.
Yeah.
And just keep your hands shut, but shake which hand the quarter is in. Okay, here's what's going to happen. I want you to watch. The quarter's in this hand, right?
Yeah.
I'm just going to do this. Open up your hand.
It's amazing.
I'm just going to take the quarter. Nothing's happened. But the penny's right here, yeah?
Yeah.
I'm just going to do this, watch. I'm going to wave the quarter over. This is what he does in the trailer. In a mysterious yet PG fashion. I wave it over like this and the magic has happened. You know that penny, that copper coin?
Yeah.
The copper coin in your hand. Open up your hand and experience the magic as that has now turned
it's like Bureau
into
exchange.
A 5p. Yeah, yeah. It's
but without the incredibly bad exchange rate.
Exactly. And that's Captain and Coke. Basically...
You can do a bit more...
Yeah, well, I'm going to get into that right now.
Yeah.
You can... Right. This has been endorsed by David Roth. You put the DVD in, and David Roth comes up first of all, and he goes, "Hi, my name's David Roth."
You just imagine Alex Pandrea off camera with his wallet with like £5 notes in.
Just keep
going,
passing them over to David. Yep.
There you just go. Say this, David.
Yeah. And apparently David is jazzed about this. He actually used those words. He's jazzed about this. It's a version of the Scotch and Soda. There's three advantages to this. The first advantage is Scotch and Soda is normally done with a half dollar and a Mexican centavo, which, like, what the hell is a Mexican centavo? This is actually made out of a quarter. It's very nicely made. It's made by Roy Coopers.
I can think of another disadvantage with it, but carry on.
Yeah, well, I'm going to tell you the advantages first, according to the Blue Crown. First advantage, it's normal coins for Americans.
Yeah, that's
anyway.
Good. That's
yeah,
brilliant.
It's a quarter and a dime.
Brilliant.
Fantastic. A cent, yes.
Yeah.
It's normal coins.
Yeah, we're in the UK.
Yeah, if you're American, it's normal coins.
Brilliant. Okay, it's normal coins.
It's normal coins. Secondly, it's got an internal shim on it, which means that the coin
you can vanish it with a magnet.
Yeah, it's got an internal shim. The third advantage is the DVD that comes with it. David says that this is an advantage. There's three routes. Right, he talks about the guy who presents it, Kevin Rylek, never really heard of him before.
He explains it, but he goes through
the history,
detail,
the gimmick.
There's
like, this is aimed at flat-out amateurs that have never done anything with coins at all. There are three routines that are taught. The first routine is what I just showed you, which he calls the classic routine.
He does a coin under watch for the vanish.
That's the second routine.
But he does it with his own watch.
He does it with his own watch. I've seen most people do that with the spectator's watch and do a watch load. He just has it already tucked under there and he does it at coin to impossible location with his own watch. The only really clever routine with it that I've never really
clever
seen
idea.
Before. Clever idea is a coin bend. He does a coin bend. He credits
using
Tim
that same move that you just did.
Yes, using that same move, but it ends up being a bent cent.
Yeah.
Which idea by Tim Trona. That's a really good idea. He then talks
two coins. One of them goes into their hand. They choose one.
Yep.
And that coin ends up bent.
Yeah, which is a nice idea.
Good idea.
Nice idea with it. To be honest, my two issues with this, and I know you've got problems with it, my two issues with it is...
I think if you're in America and you want to have that prop, the prop is nicely made.
The prop is beautifully made, yeah.
The DVD's not going to help you. You'll want the prop to do
You don't need
your
the DVD. The DVD doesn't add anything. If you were going to go to the trouble of putting a DVD with this prop,
unless you know what it is.
Yeah, but still... I've published routines with the Scotch and Soda.
There are people that don't know, though. Yeah, so you can't say the DVD's no good because somebody might buy it that wants it.
You've got the god that is David Roth there, and all you use him for is to sit there going, this is really, really good.
Yeah.
Why don't you have him say, put three or four routines...
Because that's another $2,000.
Okay, that's a good point. But you could have put some...
Allegedly.
You could have put some amazing routines on there.
Yeah.
Instead of just putting two average routines and one good routine.
Turned up to Phantasma, bought him some drinks and just... David just said, oh, stick the camera on. I love this. I'm really jazzed about this. You should get this. Is that all right, Alex? Get out my face. That's how it worked. That's how it happened.
Mm-hmm. That's the official line from David Penn. Not the Wizard Product Review, just from David Penn. no, I'm sure that's what happened. I can imagine it happening. The bottom line is, if you're in England, look elsewhere. Yeah. There is no reason to have
David's
this.
Endorsed it, David Roth. If this was for the first time you didn't have £2 2p's, right? Imagine the scenario. I'm going to put a scenario in your head. All you've had before is old English pennies and something else, right? And then all of a sudden, You know, they used to have the set, didn't they? That was like the American half dollar and the old English penny.
Yeah.
Right? And now, all of a sudden, you can get that in £2 2p.
Oh, yeah.
You would be like, this is brilliant. I can do all these routines with it. That's what it's like for some of those guys out there. But it's not like it for us in the UK.
Because we've had Eddie Gibson making stuff like this for absolutely years.
Yeah, and loads of other people as well. Yeah, they're out there now.
Yeah, exactly.
This isn't new for us to have normal coins.
No.
Maybe it's not new for the
guys out there. I don't know. You guys tell us, but that's the big pitch on this, that you can, for the first time, get them with regular American coins.
If that is the case, in America, I'd be giving this over 90%. Because as you know, I already have a routine with the £2 2p.
Yeah, you do.
But as a product for me in the UK, it doesn't add anything at all.
Yeah.
Nothing.
If you're a half experienced guy, you don't need the DVD, you just need the gimmick. If you've got need for a scotch and soda built into a quarter and a cent, get it. That is the only reason you need to get this. If you're English, European, look elsewhere, you don't need it.
You need other coins that make sense to you.
It's hard to rate. What would you rate it?
Not applicable.
Yeah, not applicable. I agree. If you're in America and what they're saying is true and you can't get something like this...
Brilliant.
Get it. Yeah, that's the official line from the Wizard Product Review. Get it. But it's impossible to... Don't get it if you're
English. You're reviewing it for us.
Yeah.
For us. Not applicable.
Not applicable. It's still going on about it.
It's still going on. Can we have an on-the-stick special?
He actually wants us to put a poll on Facebook to have you guys decide whether there should be an on... Nobody is going to go for an on-the-stick special.
That's what people say. They say this on the Magic Cafe. That's what sets us apart, that we actually dem the tricks.
Whether we can do them or not.
Give me 1 week.
And they can play Craig's drinking game as
well. Yeah, the drinking game where if I flash, you take a drink. And if I say second to none, you take two drinks.
It'll be in the manual.
Yeah, definitely. We should release that for Christmas.
We're going to do the Wizard Product Review Drinking Game.
The manual.
Well, that'll give you enough time to maybe sort it out, wouldn't it? Like 11 months.
Yeah, I could probably get it. Get it sorted around about then. Yeah, I reckon I
could
do that.
How's the tattoo going?
It's not.
Just remember, last Monday he was going, wasn't he?
Yeah, it was going.
Yes, I was, but it's going to be there. It will be there.
Right.
Yeah, you want me to shuffle these cards?
I do, yeah. You're changing the subject. Yeah, get it off the sticks, John, if
get
you
off
could.
The sticks. Yeah.
Give him a cut as well.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to be fancy about this.
Give him a shuffle. Oh, come on. Really? I was so hoping you'd screw that up as well. All right. And the cards are going to go into the box as well. This is different to the handling that he kind of does on the DVD. Oh, I should have pointed out that there's a hole in the box. And you can have the box checked as well. So check the box
out. Coming really close.
Show the hole towards the camera as well.
Yeah, and there's the hole.
And I've also got another card just there, John, on the table. Can you see? That's kind of like a prediction card. We're going to do this under laboratory conditions. That's my little bit of homage to the great one right there, Paul Daniels. There's a hole just there. Now, you see how this works? Is if I push on that card there through the hole, that will push that card out. So you've got another one there, which is looks like five of spades, that one is. So that one comes out. And each time I push through the hole, one card comes out like that. And it's a different card each time. I'm not going to show you. Yeah, that's the two of diamonds there. So if I push that, the two of diamonds will come out. Obviously,
I now see what this has got to do with the casino.
You've seen the next one. Yeah, you've seen the next one.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So I don't want you to see that. What I'm going to do, one at a time, very fairly, at fingertips, under laboratory conditions, I'm going to take one card out at a time. I'm going to push it out one card at a time.
Okay.
Okay? And they're coming out, and there's one just there. And whenever you say stop, Craig, what I'm going to do is take the cards out of the box, and we'll see which one has been left on the bottom.
That sounds fair.
So I'll just keep going here.
Stop.
You happy there?
One more.
I'm going to take one more out. Like that. Now, no funny moves.
Hang on. One more. Okay.
You happy there?
I'm happy there.
No funny moves. No sleight of hand. I'm just going to take these cards out of the box. Nothing else left in the box. And the bottom card is...
King of Clubs.
The King of Clubs, which I can leave to one side. Like that.
Okay. Okay.
You stopped on the King of Clubs, and you shuffle the cards.
That is very fair.
And the prediction matches perfectly.
Da-da-da! Boom, 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 boom. Yeah, and that's what...
Oh, you also get a black card case with it as well. You get the card case as flattened, because obviously for the trick to work, you need this opening.
Yeah.
Just
so
here.
You need the special card case.
And that's how it works. It's kind of like a shoe, isn't it, for dealing?
Basically, what it is it's a force. Now...
Oh, on the trailer, you get... He does this other routine where he's got blank bits of paper, Matthew.
Yeah.
And then he kind of puts one down and he turns it over at the end and it says the force card on it.
Yeah. Basically, you can reveal the force of the card however you want to. There's no DVD to it. You don't need a DVD. There's a very well illustrated booklet, which is very, very good. My issue with it is...
Booklet's good.
This is a very clever force. I'd even go so far as to say this is a force that would fool magicians. When you first showed it to me, it fooled me.
It would do.
It's a very clever force. And Matthew on the trailer talks about if you want to have a routine where the entire routine is built around the force of the card, this is the way to do it. Because this is the cleanest force he has ever seen. I would agree that it's a very clean force. And you can use any deck.
And if you really built up that presentation, I'm going to do something impossible. Because if I have the cards in my hand, I could use the classic force on you, for example. And if I flick through, I could use the riffle force on you.
Yes.
Or if I put the cards down like this, I could be using the crosscut force. If I do it like this, I can't use any of those forces. Do you think that could be a good presentation?
I really don't think that's probably the best presentation for laymen, no. But I'll tell you what, I do have a problem with this.
Go on then.
Right, first of all, you have to... You do...
No,
you
DVD,
can do any deck.
That's what you're saying.
No. You can use any deck. You have to use the card box, obviously, in order to do this. And you have to add a card. There is a gimmick in the deck.
There is a
gimmick that you have to add to the deck. Here's my issue. I don't need a really clever force when I'm performing for laymen. If I'm performing for magicians,
You can't do it under laboratory conditions.
I don't care.
That's what he's saying. You can change all the...
I don't care. Look,
you have to kind of go, hey, take any card, you know, I'm nice and relaxed.
Look, if I go and perform to a layman and I use a classic force, or even a freaking riffle force or a dribble force, if I use a force and I do the revelation, they're not going to go... I saw a guy last week and he did Poor Man's Casino by Matthew B. And that was a much better routine because the force was so cleaner. Look, there's a very clever guy called Di Vernon, the professor, one of the greatest magicians of all time.
Yeah.
And he turned round and he said, if you have 15 different ways to force a card and one revelation, you've got one trick. If you've got one force, but you've got 15 different revelations, you've got 15 tricks. All this does is this replaces a force that I can already do. I'm still going to reveal it exactly the same way. He doesn't really give you any clever ways to reveal it. All he does is teach you a really clever force and then charges you.
Who's that guy again?
Di Vernon.
Di Vernon. Well, I showed Mick in the shop and he thought it was brilliant.
Unbelievable.
It's
look,
true, he thought it was good.
Look, Matthew is a clever guy. I know Matthew. Matthew has threatened to kill me and threatened to kiss me in the past. I know Matthew. We've had our arguments, we've had our disagreements, but I respect him as a performer. He's a man that's fooled Penn and Teller. He's brought some of the most amazing tricks out I have ever seen.
It's a genius
and
force.
This is a genius force.
If you are
sitting there watching this and you're thinking, oh my God, I need to know how to force a card that cleanly because I have a routine in my arsenal that would be so much better if I could do a force that is that clean, then by all means get it because that is why Matthew bought it out. For me personally, I don't care about how clean the force is because I'm not performing
to layman. Now we get to the root of it. Does not care
how clean
his force is.
No, because I am performing to layman. And they are not going to appreciate how genius this is. They are not going to appreciate this. They are not going to look at this and go, that was so much cleaner than when you were here last week and you did a classic force. They're
how
not going to think
know?
That.
How do you know? You've walked away from the table. You've walked away from the table and they go, I didn't like his handling and that. And they're on YouTube and they go, he put them down in a cross. Let's Google that on YouTube.
Cross,
and I was forced, maybe he forced me to take that card cross for, oh my God, that's what he did. And then next week you go there and you kick him.
Yeah. Yeah, let's just use that argument all the way.
How much are you going to give it?
Look, it's a clever thing. It's no good for me. I'm not going to do it. I'm going to give it 50%. But hey, Matthew, if you're watching this, and I know you are, it was really nice to see you bring out a trick with a trailer that didn't expose the method.
Oh, you just...
Kudos to you.
Look, you're just reigniting that debate right before
Blackpool. It was nice. Right, he's going to be a Blackpool. Come up and kiss me. I love you, Matthew.
That's the
it's
point.
It's clever. It's magic for magicians. It is magic. It's Matrix.
This is
two cards, what Matrix is to coin magic. It is magic for magicians, and there's a place for magic for magicians. It's just not in my repertoire. And I didn't think it would be in your repertoire either.
I'm going to give you some advice. Stop drinking 3 bottles of Pepsi Max within an hour before the show. It's too much. I'm going to give it 71%.
You're sucking up to Matthew.
I think it's very, very clever. It's very clever.
If you give this a good grade, you can never again.
I'm giving it 71%. I'm not saying I'm going to use it, but I do appreciate how clever it is.
It's got a place in people's repertoire. You know, people that session and want to impress magicians, go for it.
I think it's clever. And I think if you want to focus on the free choice and make a really big thing on it, rather than go, just take any card, like most card tricks are, if you want to make a point of that, the method works and it's very, very clever.
It's genius. Matthew Beach is a genius.
Well, there you go
right now. Yeah, it's just a bit too clever for his own good. You know, he's a bit too clever for his own good. He came up with this idea and he thought...
That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. Don't forget, you've got to order by 12 o'clock on Friday midnight to get the Worker Special, have a chance of winning £200 billion worth of magic in John's head. And we're in all the usual places. Shut up, you've already said enough. Facebook, YouTube, we're on the Magic Cafe. That's it for this week. I'm Dave.
I'm Craig.